What is going on, everybody? Welcome back to the final video in this series. If you're new to the channel, my name is Matthew Huss and this is Matt Does Life. And for the past few videos, I have been reviewing Tim Sykes' 30-day boot camp, you know, guide to becoming a decent, I should say, penny stock trader with a good level of understanding of what to look for, patterns to look for, and etc. So in this video, I'm going to highlight the top five things that I took away from this course that I think is of value to the average marketplace, to the new consumer who is newer to the stock trading space or penny stocks as a whole. I definitely think it is valuable information. The course cost me $80. And to be completely honest with you, if you can't afford $80 to buy this course, you probably don't belong trading in the markets anyways, and I would advise you against that. Now, mind you, everything in this video is just my honest opinion. I'm not a finance guy. I'm not a stockbroker. I'm none of that. I am just your typical real estate agent who's out there to look and make more money and give that info to you guys so you can make better informed decisions. So, okay, so let's jump into the very first thing, and that is going to be understanding patterns. Now, mind you, this course is narrated by Tim Sykes' top student, Matt Monaco, who makes a boatload of money trading stocks and verified trades. And they go over patterns very well and what to look for. And those four main patterns that you're going to look for are the supernova pattern, your first green day, the first red day, and a multi-day breakout. So those are the patterns that they're looking for day in and day out going into the close and market open to really see what the stock may do that day, right? And they have a very detailed analysis and description of each of these patterns. I'm not going to get into those. There's plenty of research for you to do on your own in terms of understanding those patterns and if they'll fit your style. But they have a really well and detailed explanation for each of those patterns and why they're effective. The number two thing that I thought was very informative and something that I was very naive about coming into this was sector momentum. And what that frankly means is you're going to have one hot sector or multiple hot sectors of stocks that are a majority of the movers every day, right? Or maybe a week, or a whole hot sector can last a month, 6 months, maybe a year. I don't know if that's possible, but you know, a hot sector can last X amount of time. And for example, you could have weed stocks, right? You could have electric vehicle stocks. Those are some examples of hot sectors in the past that have made people a lot of money. Crypto is another current one. And with everything going on with Wall Street Bets and GameStop and AMC, something says there's going to be other hot sectors coming about merely from online promotions. So who knows? But the third and most important thing too is understanding SEC filings. And this is what each company puts out to give you an inside look behind the curtain, so to speak, with their company, how it's doing, who they're hiring, who they're firing, what their financial statements look like. And there's a lot of key drivers and information you can take away from that. However, these filings are extensive, they're very in-depth, and you probably would need some sort of law degree to understand a majority of the things in there. Tim Sykes and Matt Monaco do a great job of really digging into those filings and highlighting the info you need and what they've seen in past experience that really pertains to the stock, and it saves you a bunch of time. And when you pick up on these things, you can kind of see if it's going to affect the stock or if it's not going to affect the stock and how significant of effect they will have. The fourth thing that is of great value too, it was how to make a watch list, because you're going to see in these Discord groups, and I'm sure if you've looked at other, you know, stock trading platforms and things like that, is they all have a watch list, right? And you know, they're using scanners to come up with these watch lists, and they're looking at the volume and all this stuff. And they go over how to exactly make your own watch list so that you can have a better informed decision as to what you could potentially trade the next day or for the next week. So they give you really good analysis as to how to build your own watch list also. And the fifth and final thing, which is of great value, is a strategy that fits your schedule, right? Because not everybody's sitting at home in front of their computer all day trading stocks. So you could be working your job in the morning, working your job at nights, or maybe you have a couple jobs during the day and your time is rarely spent at home. Maybe you're a busy mom or a busy professional. You know, is swing trading a good idea for you? Or, you know, is day trading a good idea for you as a whole, right? So really cool information there just to how to trade to fit your style, because it's not a one size fits all. You don't have to sit home all day and day trade and watch stocks on your computer, you know, till 3-4 o'clock in the afternoon. You can trade certain hours of the day, or only trade certain days, or maybe only trade when you want to, when you know a stock or a sector you're very confident in is going to be moving. So those are the five things that I wanted to highlight with you guys. So we'll go over them from the top. Number one was patterns and understanding them and what they are. Number two was sector momentum, how to identify them and how to play those sectors to get some money in your pocket. Number three was understanding SEC filings and what to look for within those. Number four was how to make an effective watch list from scanners and the types of stocks that you could potentially trade that day or week. And then number five is using a strategy to fit your schedule. But some, six thing or a bonus here is Matt Monaco and Tim Sykes, they reviewed their trades, their live trades from, you know, I believe it was April of last year. And then Matt Monaco recaps his $250,000 month or year that he had. I think it was his 250K month. But he deep dives into his entries, his exits, why he played those. And, you know, just taking notes from those videos alone proved to have great value. But how I want to end the video is this. Guys, this is only a minor stepping stone. There are many other things you can learn. And obviously, this is a marathon, not a sprint. And I mean, if you're going to think you're coming into this going to make 5, 10, 15, 20K a month or 30K a month, you're just not realistic. And I would advise you just to keep your own money in your pocket and save yourself the trouble and the stress and probably the emotional hatred you're going to have on yourself. But is it to say you can't make money? Absolutely not. I've made a few hundred dollars so far myself just playing around. I wouldn't necessarily say they were strategic, but I did have a little bit more of an understanding of why things were doing or what they're doing and how they could potentially play out. So I've made some money on this. It's nothing groundbreaking. I'm going to keep my day job as a real estate agent, but I am going to be scaling up more and more when it comes to trading stocks, so to speak. So guys, that is my detailed review on this. Please watch the previous videos just to kind of see where I'm coming from and how everything was shaking out week over week. And I think I'm going to keep doing this going forward in terms of reviewing other courses for you guys. I'll front the capital up front and let you know if it's worth it so you can come here first and check it out. Drop a comment down below as if there's any other courses you would like to see or what your thoughts were on some of the information I provided in this one. And I will see you guys in the next video. Be sure to subscribe, like, and stick around because there's plenty of more really cool content coming, getting a new camera and some other stuff. So look forward to sharing all that with you. And until the next time, see you.